Masters, mistresses, the Doctor requires materials in order to maintain the TARDIS and ensure continued functionality. He similarly requires carbon-based comestibles to sustain his own biological functions and existence. Master would never say this, but he requires aid beyond that supplied by this unit in order to acquire these. To aid the Doctor in his various tasks and creations, this can be most effectively achieved via Patreon or Substack subscriptions, or through donations directly to PayPal. Or if you desire physical goods in return for your contributions, written accounts of my travels with the Doctor are also available on Amazon. Links are in the description below. Thank you, Masters, Mistresses.
Out of 10 years' growth.
You seen that up yonder?
I have. A light in a deserted house.
Him as lived there died of the typhoid. Bad drains.
Maybe he's come back for a squint at the drains what killed him.
Reckon it's our duty to have a squint too, eh?
Oh, aye. Our duty.
No warrant.
Give him the yell.
Anyone out?
Watson, I was merely creating a little excitement to ease the boredom of inactivity. What use are brains in our profession when there is no real crime to detect? Nothing complex, nothing worthy of my talents. Interesting.
What? That chap looking for an address?
Yes, the ex-sergeant of Marines. He works for the government now, police in all probability.
How on earth can you know that?
Ah, he's found us.
I'll go.
For Mr. Holmes. Mr. Sherlock Holmes.
Thank you. May I ask what your trade might be?
Government employment, sir. Police work, as you might say.
Were you ever at the colors?
Man and boy, sir. Marines. 3 stripes up. Old army man yourself, sir.
Briefly, yes. Good day to you.
And you, sir.
will never fathom how you do it. That man.
Former sergeant.
Of Marines. Fight. For you.
From Gregson at Scotland Yard. You remember Gregson?
That smart young chap?
Smart. He'd know a hawk from a handsaw, I dare say. Old rival of friend Lestrade. No love lost between those two gentlemen. Ye gods, did I say just now there were no crimes worthy of our minds? Watson, your hat. The game's afoot. Stop, driver, stop.
How much, cabbies?
1 shilling even, sir. Thank you, sir.
No, ma'am, no. Go back the way you came.
Well, there goes another man in London who thinks you're mad.
Perhaps you should have told him you're my doctor, Watson.
Found anything?
It rained last night. For the first time in over a week. Driest autumn I can recall.
Here, sir. You can't go in there. Who do you think he is, then?
Sherlock Holmes. Found something?
Six feet, if he was an inch.
Holmes, very kind of you to come. I've left everything as it was. Nothing's been touched.
Nothing, Gregson? Was it entirely necessary to run a herd of buffalo across the pathway repeatedly? Or had you drawn your own conclusions before the stampede?
I've had much to do. Inside, I mean. I was relying on my colleague to look after things out here.
Your colleague?
Mr. Lestrade.
Oh, so. And what have you and your colleague Lestrade found out thus far?
I believe we've done all that can be done.
How much is that?
Deuce little. It's a queer business. Very complex.
You're stumped?
No.
Why send for us, then?
I thought you might be interested.
So I am, Gregson. So I am very interested. Did you come here by cab?
No.
Did Lestrade?
No. Why?
Good. Very good. Capital, in fact. So, let us go and consider the unfortunate gentleman.
Who was he?
Enoch J. Drebber, of Cleveland, Ohio.
Late of Cleveland, Ohio. Anything known?
Not much, I'm afraid. After you, Doctor.
Good morning, Dr. Watson.
Oh, is it Lestrade?
No, it's not. This is a bad business.
Who found the body?
We did, sir. Proper horrible it was too, sir. Me and Murcher here...
All in good time, my dear fellow. Facts first, details after. Would you mind?
Yes, sir.
Puzzle to me.
You're sure there is no wound?
Positive, none.
And then the blood on the floorboards belongs to a second individual, presumably the murderer. If murder has been committed.
If murder's been committed?
How was this done then, do you suppose?
I never suppose, Lestrade. It biases one's judgment. The body hasn't been moved.
You see him as we found him, Mr. Holmes?
Just as we found him, sir. Laid out stark and cold and... Blimey.
Very well. Take him to the mortuary. There's nothing to be gained by keeping him.
A ring. woman's wedding ring.
That complicates matters.
Perhaps it simplifies them. What else did you find about his person?
Constable?
Baron of London. What do you think of that, Watson?
I couldn't afford such a timepiece on an army pension. The gentleman had money.
But no purse. He carried only loose change to the value of £7 and a few pence.
We've already discounted robbery as a motive.
Enoch J. Drebber, Cleveland.
Joseph Stangerson, Esquire. To be called for at the American Exchange, the Strand.
From the Atlantic Steamship Company, giving details of sailing times. The unfortunate Mr. Drebber was to return to America.
Anything known about this Joseph Stangerson?
I sent one of my men around to the American Exchange. They've no forwarding address for him.
You've telegraphed Cleveland?
Yes, sir, asking for any information which might assist our inquiry.
What information specifically?
About Stangerson.
Nothing more crucial?
No, sir.
Then telegraph again, ma'am.
This is my case, Mr. Holmes.
I believe I've just solved it for you. Forget the ifs, gentlemen. It's murder, right enough. And here is the name that will lead us to the murderer.
Jimson, Mr. Lestrade, Evening News.
It is my professional opinion that the word Rach is the name Rachel, and that the writer, undoubtedly the murderer, was disturbed before he had time to finish inscribing said name upon said wall.
Is it true that Mr. Holmes is involved with the case?
Mr. Holmes has volunteered his services, yes.
And what is Mr. Holmes' opinion?
Lestrade's conclusions.
All piffle, my dear chap. Utter tosh. 6'7¾". Splendid, Watson. We are not looking for any Rachel. Indeed, far from it.
You can't be, sir.
Indeed, I can be.
But where's the evidence?
Everywhere. One finds what one seeks, young man, although it does help to know what one is looking for, or rather, how to interpret what one is looking at.
Mr. Holmes.
Recall our meeting earlier today. The wheel marks on the drive were fresh and deep. Since neither you nor Lestrade arrived by cab, they had to be made last night.
But what's that mean?
It means, Gregson, that two individuals arrived by cab during the night, and one of them was Enoch J. Drebber.
And the other, Stangerson?
Perhaps. If Stangerson stands 6 feet tall, wears hobnailed boots, and has long nails on the fingers of his right hand. A few indications only, Gregson, that they may assist you in apprehending the murderer.
Oh, we are looking at murder, then?
A very complicated murder, Watson.
No, it's too fantastic. There's nothing to work on but a body, a ring, a half-finished word. You couldn't deduce so much from so little.
Again, recall our earlier meeting. You found me studying a puddle. Drebber wore patent leather shoes and walked around the puddle. His murderer, however, wore hobnailed boots and stepped across the puddle, a stride of 4 feet taken without effort and indicating legs long enough to substantiate a height of at least 6 feet.
Very well. What about the fingernail?
Observe the word. It was inscribed with a forefinger. See how the plaster has been scratched around the downstroke. Whoever wrote the word with his forefinger had untrimmed nails.
Elementary?
Quite so.
Then who is Rachel?
A figment of Lestrade's imagination. You discovered the body, Constable Rance?
First upon the scene, sir.
After you had found the body and raised the alarm, what did you see then?
Well, sir, confusing it was, but I... Yes, I saw a drunkard, sir. I saw a man far gone in liquor.
Describe him.
Well, sir, he were a long chap.
6 feet and more?
Easily that, sir. Muffler covering half his face, long brown coat. Only, now that you force me mind to it, sir,
I don't think the blinder was tight at all.
No, Constable, neither do I.
Is it important, do you think, sir?
Perhaps. What became of him?
I shooed him off, sir. Sent him about his business.
Was he carrying a whip?
Not as I recall, sir.
And whoever she may be, the mysterious Rachel is the heart of this grim and terrible business.
What did Constable Rance have to say?
He gave me the identity of the murderer.
Rachel?
There is no Rachel. There's a woman involved, of course. The wedding ring we found shows that. But she is long dead.
But the name on the wall?
Did you notice anything about it?
Well, it was a medieval script. Germanic.
Exactly. But contrived, my dear fellow. How rough in languages, Watson?
Some bush, too. A smattering of Hindi. I can negotiate the menu in a French restaurant.
No German. R-A-C-H-E in German is Rache, which means revenge, Watson. Someone else is going to die. I have an answer to my American telegram. My view of the case is the correct one.
Oh, what is your view of the case, Holmes?
Do you still have your service revolver, Watson?
Yes.
Better clean and load it. He will be a desperate man.
Who?
The murderer. He'll be calling this evening between 8 and 9. Read this.
Found. In Brixton Road this morning. A plain gold wedding ring. Apply Dr. Watson. 221B Baker Street, between 8 and 9 this evening.
Excuse me for using your name, old fellow. My fiddle would be better for new strings.
Assuming anyone does apply, I don't have a wedding ring to give them.
This will do. Keep your pistol ready. When the fellow comes, speak to him calmly and don't alarm him by looking at him too hard.
But why should the murderer be anxious for this ring?
It's precious to him, Watson. More precious than a man's life. The murderer will risk anything rather than lose the ring. I believe he dropped it while stooping over Drebber's body. After leaving the house, he discovered his loss and hurried back and found Constables Rance and Murcher already there.
Yes, but who is he? Stangerson?
Definitely not.
That telegram you received this morning told you as much?
Yes. They're being followed, Watson. Clumsy Wiggins. That won't do, boy.
No fooling you, Mr. Holmes.
War your men. Baker Street irregulars. These youngsters go everywhere and see everything. They're as sharp as needles and worth a dozen men in blue.
There we are.
There we are, too.
Have you found it, Wiggins?
No, sir. Not yet, we ain't.
Keep on until you do. There are your wages. Back with a better report next time.
Right you are, Mr. Holmes.
Morning, gentlemen. Mr. Gregson's compliments, sir. And would you join him at the station? He's got the Brixton murderer, sir.
His name is Arthur Charpentier, lieutenant in Her Majesty's Navy. His mother runs a boarding house in Torquay Terrace, where Drebber and Stangerson stayed prior to coming up to London the day before yesterday.
Have you got a confession from him?
Not yet. What I do have is evidence and motive. The American Exchange had no forwarding address for Enoch J. Drebber. I traced him through the label in his hat.
Underwood and Sons, Camberwell Road.
The man at Underwood's remembered making the hat for an American gentleman living at Torquay Terrace.
He wasn't a gentleman. He was an animal, a drunken, bullying animal. He treated my sister abominably.
And that is why you killed him, Lieutenant Charpentier, because of your sister.
I didn't kill him. I felt like it, but I didn't know.
How tall are you, Lieutenant?
Tall? Why? 5 feet 9?
That proves the young man's innocence, Gregson.
Sorry, Mr. Holmes. I've got the man and the motive.
Good morning, gentlemen. Who's he?
The Brixton murderer. I've had him in custody for 5 hours.
Then he isn't the murderer.
You've found Stangerson?
I have indeed, at Halliday's private hotel.
What's he got to say?
Nothing. Mr. Joseph Stangerson was killed by a deep knife wound to the left side which penetrated the heart.
Who discovered the body?
Me, sir. The gentleman asked to be called for breakfast. I come up and there he was. Blood everywhere. Cool.
And you?
I'm the milkman, sir.
You saw the murderer?
I did, sir. He was climbing out that very window there. A ladder was up against the wall outside. I thought he was the hotel carpenter.
Man you saw was tall, wearing a long brown overcoat.
A scarf and hat. That's him, all right.
Hobnailed boots?
Yes. Cleveland, October the 3rd. J.H. is in Europe. Strychnine.
And the other pill?
Aspirin.
I don't need a microscope to tell me Stangerson wasn't poisoned, Mr. Holmes.
No, but Drebber was.
What?
Wait. Our man miscalculated here. There will be no more murders.
Oh, yes. Certain of that, are you?
As certain as I am of the murderer's identity and whereabouts. No. Do not press me for that information, gentlemen. I have my own methods, and should this dangerous and clever man have the slightest suspicion I am onto him, he would vanish without trace and make a laughing stock of all of us.
You'll notice in the newspapers, sir, a wedding ring what I lost last night in the Brixton Road, sir.
Oh, is this the ring?
Bless you, sir, the very one.
Then I am happy to restore it to its rightful owner, madam.
Oh, bless you, sir, bless you, bless you.
Think nothing of it, I assure you. Good night. Not what I expected, Holmes.
J.H.'s accomplice, Watson. She'll lead me to him.
J.H.?
Drive to 13 Duncan Street, Houndsditch.
And right you are, Mum. We're here, Mum. Mum? What the?
No, madam.
Idiot Holmes.
Baker Street driver.
I don't like it. He slipped through our fingers.
Not yet. No ships sail for America until Saturday. That gives us 2 days.
If he's sailing to America...
Where else? His work here is completed. And of course, gentlemen, there are our reputations to consider.
He's a-coming, sir.
Oh, how the deuce did you get in here, boy?
Slipped through the pantry window, sir.
Never seen such cheeses. Best I ever had.
You're certain it's the man himself, Wiggins?
The very one you asked for, Mr. Holmes.
Good boy. Take this and don't go through the front door.
I wouldn't know a front door, sir. They ain't no use in my line of work.
Won't be necessary, Watson. I have these. There's the cab. Conceal yourselves, gentlemen. Watson, ask the driver to lend a hand with the luggage, would you?
In here, driver.
Evening, sir.
Yes. Help me with the straps on the large truck, would you, cabman? Would you, cabman?
Looking for Haddrick.
Mr. Drebber. I'm Mr. Drebber to you and everyone on my land from now on. Is that understood, Joe Stangerson?
Sure, Mr. Drebber. You're the boss man.
And don't you forget it, boy. Pretty, ain't she, Joe? Pretty as a picture, that Lucy Ferrier.
Condolences, son.
I'm sorry about your father, Mr. Drebber.
Call me Enoch. Do, Miss Lucy?
No, I couldn't.
How about husband, then? Dear old Daddy always said you and me'd make a fine couple.
You don't have no shame at all. Come on, Lucy.
I own your land, Jack Ferrier.
Maybe, but you don't own us.
Mrs. Drebber. Mrs. Lucy Drebber.
Bad times come, Lucy.
What he said about me calling him husband?
Forget it. That man's the serpent in Eden.
Oh, there's someone following us.
Stangerson?
I can't tell.
I'm looking for an old friend of my pa's, Jack Ferrier. You know him?
Reckon so, if I ain't too old to know my own name. Your pa and me was like brothers. I saw you christened. You're almost kinfolk to me and Lucy. You planning to stay here, Betts?
I'm heading north. Partner and me got a stake in a silver mine. I got ambitions.
Oh.
I had him myself once when I first come out here. All gone now. Like with Enoch J playing high and mighty, this valley's turning sour. I'd even think about moving on myself once this fool leg's mended. Yeah, bad time for it to happen. Harvest coming on and all. Only me and Lucy to work the place. That silver mine of yours paying any, son?
Ah, guess it can wait.
Well, this here's your home so long as you're in the valley, Jefferson. Hope you're here. I can't rightly decide which of you two youngins is blushing the rest.
Says he struck pay dirt. I don't reckon to be gone long. I aim to be back for the wedding, leastways.
He's gone, Mr. Drebber.
That's good, Joe. That's real good.
That little gal just don't care for you, Mr. Drebber.
What's that matter? I'm closing you down, Jack. I need your place.
This is my land, Enoch Drebber.
You got no legal claim on it, Jack.
I had your father's word.
Yeah, well, old daddy ain't doing too much talking these days. And I got plans for the valley.
I put 15 years into this place.
Pity about that. You did a real nice job. But that's progress. Of course, we could come to an agreement. That daughter of yours is a fine grown-up gal, Jack Ferrier. Can't imagine a finer candidate for Mrs. Enoch J. Drebber.
Get off my land. Go on, get.
It's your land for 3 more weeks, Jack Ferrier. Either I get me a wife, or you can start packing. Good morning, Miss Lucy.
One week to go, Pa.
Lucy, I've been thinking a whole lot about Jefferson. I always did want to see me a silver mine. Yes.
Dragged her back here and married her. I lived a long life, but I ain't never seen a bride weeping at her own wedding.
What killed her?
Grief, boy, grief. She gave me this for before she died. Said she wouldn't be buried wearing it. Someone should have loved her.
I did. Two lives for your one precious life, Lucy. If it takes forever, I swear.
Jefferson Hope?
I am.
Rickson, have one of your men run for an ambulance. Quickly, man. There's not a moment to lose.
Lucy. 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 Lucy.
Cleveland, Cleveland, one way. Second class?
Yes.
First class, booking for two, Cleveland to New York. Name a driver. Thank you, sir.
I told the police you was old rivals in love.
Well, that's all in the past. We'll be on our way to Europe next week. Forget Jefferson Hope and Hope.
Them two devils led me the merriest chase you could imagine. I spent years chasing them. But it were a work of justice for poor Lucy and old Jack Ferrier.
Racha.
Racha. That's revenge, as them Germans say it. Thought I was being real smart using that bit of German talk to throw you off my scent. I near got Drebber and Joe Stangerson in Berlin, you know.
Is that where you acquired the strychnine tablets? In Berlin?
Sure was. Them two lit out for England and by the time I got me to London, I was down on my last dime. I needed work real bad.
And that's when you took up driving a hansom.
I don't know who you are, sir, but seems to me you know more about me than I do.
Perhaps. And that's my function.
Then, just the other night, I got me a fare to Euston Station.
I got business, Joe. Personal business.
All I'm saying is, it's wiser if we stick together, Mr. Drebber.
You say too much, Joe. I'll be back by 11. Now, you just hole up in Halliday's hotel, and you stay there till I show. Understand?
Whatever you say, Mr. Drebber.
Right. Whatever I say.
Cab, sir.
Torquay Terrace. And make it a quick trip.
From my sister. You come near her again and I'll kill you, Drebber. My word on that, you animal.
You haven't changed one word. That makes my chore a sight easier.
Stop at the next saloon or public house or whatever it is you call it over here. Wait for me.
An hour or two more ain't gonna try my patience.
Thank you.
He can drive me to Halliday's private hotel. Houston Station.
Your ear. Shut down Jack Ferrier.
No! Joe Stangerson did that!
Then he'll pay for that old man's life. And you pay for Lucy's.
Don't kill me!
One of these got strychnine. Take your chances, Prep.
You're mad!
Drebber killed himself.
With a little prompting, you'll admit.
Don't upset him, Holmes. He's getting weaker.
I won't go yet. Just shows the power of prayer. Or hatred.
Or love. When did you realize you had lost Lucy's wedding ring?
On my way to finding Stangerson. I had to go back for it. It was like I'd lost Lucy all over again.
And when you returned to the Brixton Road, the police were already upon the scene.
That's why I had to act drunk. I believe I had that Bobby fooled, too. Did I?
I think you did.
I knew Stangerson would wait for his boss for as long as his boss wanted to keep him waiting. So I just scouted the place out. Looks real easy. Drebber's dead.
No.
The hour of reckoning's come for you two. I give you the choice of poisoned pills, same as I give your boss. He flung himself at me. And while we were struggling, he rolled over on his knife. He would have died in any case. Providence wouldn't have allowed Joe Stangerson to go unpunished. I went on cabin, intending to raise the fare home. Then, tonight, This raggedy youngster pulls me up and says, a gentleman wants a cab from 221B Baker Street. I knew where I was going, but it didn't seem like much to worry about after they arrested Charpentier. Maybe I wanted to be caught. Guess I got my wish, huh? Leastways, justice has been done for Lucy and old Jack Ferrier.
Who was it you sent to collect the ring from Dr. Watson?
Wouldn't do no good for you to know. After she gave you the slip, she lit out and took Lucy's ring with her.
Not the original. I substituted another. I knew you'd try to get it back.
You was on me from the first, huh?
You left a distinct trail for me to follow.
No more questions, Holmes. No more time. Neither.
Whatever our personal feelings in the matter, the law must be complied with. When he is fit enough, the prisoner will be brought before the magistrates and formally charged with murder.
He's guilty. Legally, I mean. But morally, I wonder.
Gentlemen, a higher judge has taken the matter of Jefferson Hope in hand. How did you know the name of the man we were looking for, Holmes?
The wedding ring stirred my curiosity, Watson. I telegraphed the chief of police in Cleveland asking for details of Drebber's marital status. The answer was conclusive. Drebber was a widower. However, a couple of years ago, he sought police protection from an old rival in love named Jefferson Hope. Hope was arrested, and Drebber and Stangerson set sail for Europe. Shortly after his release from jail, Hope also booked a passage for Europe. The conclusion was elementary, my dear Watson. What do you know about elephants, Watson?